Hi. In this time, we are going to create shield effect using material. First of all, create a material and then click to open a window. Next, set the material's blend mode to translucent. Next, hold down number 3 on the keyboard and click to create two constant 3 vectors. Set one of the constant 3 vectors as white and the others as desired colors you want. Next, create a Fresnel node. Then, click while holding down L on the keyboard to create a Lerp node and then connect two constant 3 vector nodes with a Fresnel node to the Lerp node as shown in the video. After that, when you preview the Lerp node, you can see that the border of the outside is white by the Fresnel node and the inside is blurred with your chosen color. Once verified, connect the Lerp node to the emissive color. Next, create a depth fade node. Then, create a 1- node and connect it with the depth fade node to make the inside transparent. Next, create a max node and connect the Fresnel node with the 1- node. Now, if you connect the max node to opacity, the value of the inner transparent part and the outer white border part will be displayed by the max node. Next, create a texture sample node by clicking while holding down the T on the keyboard. Set texture sample to Tech Hex tile texture provided by Start Content. Next, create a TechScored node. Then, while holding down keyboard M, click to create a multiply node, and hold down the S key and click to create a parameter node and then, set the value. Next, connect the TechScored and parameter nodes to the multiply node, and then connect the multiply node to the texture sample node to adjust the UVs of the texture. Next, create a generated band node. When you preview the generated band node, you can see that a white line is drawn in the middle. After that, create two parameter nodes and connect them to the width and sharpness of the generated band node so that the white line can be adjusted by the parameter value. Next, create a panner node and connect it to the input coordinate of the generated band node. And if you set speed Y to a negative value in the panner node, you will see a white line going down repeatedly from top to bottom. Now, create a multiply node and connect the blue channel of the texture sample to the generated band, and you can see that the hex texture is combined with the white line coming down. Finally, create a max node and connect the previously created max node with the multiply node, and then connect it to the opacity node. If you look at the side viewport, you can find the outer border and the inner texture moving. Once confirmed, save and exit to the content browser. In place actors, place the sphere actor at a proper place on the level, and then set the sphere actor's scale to large. Then, right-click on the material created so far to create an instance and apply it to the sphere actor. Now open the material instance window and adjust the parameters as you want to see the material change.